Well, with the Al Capone books, the research so completely fed the process. I mean, the truth is so much weirder than any fiction I could possibly come up with. I mean, just the title, Al Capone Does My Shirts, came from research. Because it turns out if you were a kid living on Alcatraz because your father was a guard there, your laundry was done by the convicts. And Al Capone's first job on Alcatraz was in the laundry. So that phrase, Al Capone does my shirts, was accurate for some of the kids who lived on the island. And there was also an exchange via the laundry. So the guards that were most hated by the convicts did not send their clothes through the laundry because they knew it would come back mangled. Too much starch, cuffs sewn together, not enough buttons, etc. Because the convicts were making a statement about that guard. And so that fed me all kinds of ideas. The research for the book in every way was helpful in every chapter. There's one chapter in the first book, Al Capone Does My Shirts, about what happened when Al Capone's mom came to visit. And that is what happened to her. And I won't spoil it for you if you haven't read the book, but that's something that I literally picked up the true anecdote and then I wove the fiction around it. Well, that was a fascinating and educational process for me trying to understand what was accurate because there were so many myths about Alcatraz. And so one of my rules was two sources for something. But in some ways, that isn't really even good enough, you know? So you could say, well, if you actually could talk to someone who was there, who I did. I am an honorary member of the Alcatraz Alumni Association. And so I know on a first name basis people who were guards there, who were convicts there, who were kids growing up there. And so when I had a question, I could actually ask them. So that was just an amazing thing. But people's memories are not always accurate. So I would even verify when you hear something with someone else whose memory might be a little better and some written sources. But as one man who grew up on the island said to me, you know, it's the people that write the books that become the authorities, and that may not even necessarily be true. So that was eye-opening for me.